morning, and how was your weekend? I hope it went well. All right. Last week, we did some work on descriptive writing, and I gave you some questions to attempt. Now, for this week, we will be looking at comprehension. And we are drawing our comprehension passage this time, not from the Nigerian Primary English, but from your other English textbook, English Skills. And our topic for that is Bell the Cat, and it is drawn from the English Skills textbook, page 64. On page 64, we have the comprehension passage there, while on page 65, you have the activities to be attempted. Now, as the custom demands in primary 2, we usually sort out new words and their meaning, and that is what you are having on the board. Firstly, we have mice as the plural of mouse, the species of rats. Then, another new word you will also come across while you're reading is fewer. What is the meaning of fewer? A smaller number of persons or things. Okay? Then we have invitation. Invitation. What is the meaning of invitation? The act of inviting someone. So when you are inviting someone, you are sending an invitation to that person. Number 4, we have marvelous. We usually hear, you are marvelous. You know, we usually sing, marvelous God. Oh, this is marvelous. What does it tell you? It means something that is extremely good or enjoyable. Take note of the word extremely. So the thing is not just good, but at an extra distance. Okay, number 5, we have delighted. Delighted is the past form of delight. So, what is the meaning of delight itself? It means full of great pleasure or satisfaction. Oh, I am delighted to have you with us. That means I am filled with so much pleasure to have you with us. Then number 6, we have whiskers. We usually see it as a long, stiff hair that grow near the mouth of some animals. Some animals, they have it. We see that also, I think, in cats. We also see whiskers. So mice, usually, they have whiskers. Now, another new word we also come across by going through the passage is stroke. What does it mean to stroke? It's to rub gently in one direction. Like for those of us who have some animals as pets, maybe dogs, when we want to calm them down or make them a little bit relaxed, you see, you find yourself or you see people stroking their heads. That is rubbing it one direction and it calms them. Now, having known these new words and their meaning, I have, like I said earlier, that we are taking our passage from the English Skills textbook, pages 64 and 65, and on page 65, where you have the exercise, you are to attempt the whole of exercise A and exercise B. That means you are answering everything on page 65. Thank you and have a nice day.